Very good morning to all of you. Welcome to Narayana online classes. Today I am going to discuss 7th class chemistry assignment. Assignment number 11. Topic is changes around us. In which the first one is when turmeric is added to lime water, it turns into which color? The turmeric is added to the lime water, the color it will be red. So here answer. When turmeric is added to lime water, it turns into red in color. Next, define crystallization. What is the crystallization? Crystallization means separating the soluble solid substance from the solution by heating. That is called as a crystallization. So here answer, the process of separating a soluble solid from the solution on heating is called crystallization. For example, if we take the salt water in a beaker and which is continuously heated on certain temperature, the water it will be evaporated, the remaining salt crystals which is left on the beaker. This process is called as a crystallization. Next, how do you make crystallization of urea? Okay, how can we prepare the urea in the form of the crystallization? First, we have to take the one clean test tube. In that, place the some amount of the urea. Later, few drops of water which is dropped into the test tube. Then what happened? In the test tube, urea and water both are present. Now heat that test tube. Then what happened? The urea which is dissolved in the water. Like continuously add some more amount of the urea. And what happened? At one particular state, the urea cannot be dissolved in the water. Then stop the heating process, and which is cools down. After some time, we can observe the formation of the urea crystals. This process is known as a crystallization. If come to the answer, take some water in a test tube and add urea to it. Heat the test tube till all the urea dissolves and more urea to it. Keep on adding to it until no more urea can be dissolved in it. That means the urea continuously we are adding in the test tube. The test tube which is containing the water. After some time what happened? Let the solution cool down for some time. Observe the test tube. After about half an hour, we get large size crystals of urea. Next, explain the process of making crystallization of copper sulfate. Now here, come to the answer. Take some hot saturated solution of the copper sulfate in a test tube. What is the meaning? First, we have to take the clean test tube. Later, some amount of the water which is poured into the test tube. Later, add the few copper sulfate crystals. Then heat the test tube. What happened? The copper sulfate which is completely dissolved in the water. Then which makes the formation of the copper sulfate solution. Next, pour some of it in an evaporating dish. And take the one evaporating dish in which pour the copper sulfate solution. Then what happened? Allow the solution to cool quickly. Observe with a magnifying glasses the size, color and shape of the crystals formed. After some time, we can observe the formation of the copper sulfate crystals. The crystals which is in a small size and the color is the blue color. Next, fifth one and last one. Complete the table. What they given? They given us some items. We have to identify which is the physical change or chemical change with the reason. You all of you very well know about the physical change and chemical change. What is the physical change? A change which can be reversed by reversing the conditions. That is called as a physical change. The change which cannot be reversed by reversing the conditions. That is called as a chemical change. You can understand. Now here I will explain the examples. I will explain the some items with reasons and examples. Now here come to the item. Preparation of the idli mix. Here we are preparing the idli. How we can prepare? By using the some ingredients. Okay, Nandi. Now it is the which change? Physical change. Why it is the physical change? Because no new substance is formed. No new substance is so preparation of idli mix. After preparation of the idli, which is the example of the physical change only. Next, refining of fruits. Refining of fruits. Here what happened? This is the example for the chemical change. After refining, which cannot be comes into the original state. That's why here what happened? New substance is formed. That's why which is the example for the refining of fruits is chemical change. Next, taking tablets, capsules and syrups. What is the change? This is also chemical change because this is the biochemical change. After taking the tablets, syrups, which is digested and which cannot be reversed. That's why which is the example for chemical change. Next, applying pain balm for different kinds of pains. What is the example? This is the example for the physical change. Because here the change of state only change, but here no new substance is formed. So these are the examples for the physical change and the chemical change. I hope you all are understanding today. Thank you to everyone.